He has a reputation of being one of the foremost trial attorneys in the United States, but he is also an author. And we are just honored to have in the studio with us today Mike Papantonio to talk about his latest work. Welcome.
Thank you, Sue.
I was so excited when I saw this. I'm kind of, you've got to come tell us about this. Your book, Law and Disorder. First, I want to ask you, how did you get into writing?
Well, I mean, there's so many stories that you run into as an attorney. There's stories that you want to tell that you know never will be told unless you put it down on paper. And so that's a big motivating factor.
But one might expect that you write a story, though, that's more legalese from the standpoint of, okay, I had a case and here's the case. Yeah. But this is a novel.
Yeah, it's a novel. What I tried to do was mix up real stories that the media is not able to tell. Because they're fairly complex stories, but they're adventure stories, they're thriller stories. And this is what we do every day. As a trial attorney, the things that are in this book actually happened, with the exception of a couple of issues. But the point is, you're able to take those stories and you're able to tell people, for example, every day, they're busy. They don't have time to find out what's happening to them politically, socially. They don't hear the backstories. This is a book that hopefully entertains, and at the same time, you walk away from the entertainment saying, I wish I knew more about that topic. It may be a political issue, maybe a social issue. And so that's the combination I've tried to reach in this book.
Set the stage a little bit for us with Law and Disorder.
Nicholas Deca Thomas is an attorney who handles mass tort cases. And it centers in this Pensacola area, and it's based. It actually starts off with a case that our firm actually handled. It's called the Ranadol case, which is not actually the name of the product, but it was a birth control case, and it then leads the reader into understanding how it is that the pharmaceutical industry is able to get away with some of the things that they get away with. In this story, we have a young lady who dies because of the Ranadol product. And then from there, it tells the backstory. How did that happen? What were the politics behind it? How did what did the regulators fail to do? What happened to allow this to occur? So it's told in a fiction setting. But at the end of it, you understand that the issues that are actually talked about actually occur every day.
And you were saying that, is it just for people who might have be from the area or have been around for a long time, that you might recognize some
I think
some
anybody,
people?
Yes, Sue, I think anybody who reads the book is going to say, well, not every character is from here, but you're going to see a lot of them from here. And all of it is based here. And I think it's fun, certainly, from anybody in this area. I think the reviews on it have been very good. I'm very pleased with the pre-sale reviews. The book comes out in September. It's going to be released the second week of September. And I think that one thing that the reviews liked about it was it's a simple story about a family in crisis because of something that Nicholas Deca Thomas, that's something that occurs in his life as a trial lawyer.
And to tease people a little more, this, you tell me, is going to be the first of a trilogy.
It'll be the first in three books, and each book will continue telling more of the story. It tells more of the story about the Deca Thomas family. It tells more of the story about new characters that are set. And it propels the same idea, though, Sue. That idea is that there are a lot of important things that we can learn by a well-written fiction book. Grisham was a master of it. When he would write a book, you'd come away and say, I really learned something there, and I was entertained. And that's my goal with these books.
Law and Disorder, it's a legal thriller. The author, Mike Papantonio. Again, thanks so much for taking time
to be with
us today.
Thank you, Sue. I appreciate it.